As the economic environment improves, any possibility that any of these loans are going to get better, that there may be the opportunity to lift the price tag on this package?
Yes, there is absolutely this possibility. You have to consider that at the end of 2020, we made the massive deleveraging, so moving our total amount of non-performing loans now net is 10 billion euros. We used to have more than 40 billion euros at the beginning of the crisis. And today, the crisis with the recovery of the economy in Italy is getting better. So I think that it is possible to have also some write backs. The situation is really positive. And the evidence of this is the massive increase in commissions and wealth management that we had in the last quarter. So I have to tell you that there are significant signals of very positive situation in the future coming to 2021.
Carlo, I was looking at the language and the wording in your document today and talk about being a growth accelerator for Italy, for households, but also businesses, which sort of piqued my attention about the sort of activity you're now seeing in loans, guarantees, leasing, factoring in particular, as a lot of companies gear up from not much activity, but then trying to weather unpredictable demand. Just how active is this side of the business and as you talk about supporting the Italian economy?
So the real point in Italy is that at the end, construction and production didn't stop during the pandemic situation. And you know that industry and construction are a significant portion of the real economy in the country. Then at the same time, light lockdowns allowed a lot of companies to continue to work. So my expectation is that there are sectors like tourism that are impacted, but at the end, during this summer, there will be a recovery. Also, government made the right job, and we are ready to support the next generation EU funds with more than 400 billion euros in the next years. So I'm pretty confident that Italy can really become a country in which GDP can grow in a significant way. Our expectation is 4% this year, but also in the medium term, there could be a growth between 1% and 2% GDP that for Italy is a good growth.
Carlo, your bank has always been considered one of the best in breed, and I was struck by the comment in the announcement about the asset quality with low risk profile. What do you make of all the racier business that's been done across in some of your banking peers around Archegos? Has there been excessive risk chasing in your view?
So I think that that we made the right job in terms of reduction of low performing loans. Then at the end, we had zero level two, level three assets, and we are today probably one of the best players in terms of risk profile and the correlation with significant excess capital. If you look at the Italian banking system, I think that has been done a lot of job also from the other players, and I don't think there could be any kind of situation problematic in the country looking at the banking sector. So also Italian banking sector as a whole is in good shape, in my opinion.